Starting out or like starting up. Can you introduce them quickly? I send them to you on Skype. Otherwise, I can start introducing Sagista while you talk about those or while you read those notes.
You can start. I'll watch them as much now.
All right, I'm going to go an overview here. I'll find the stuff I have to say about these two guys. Alright, so what we got from them is that they consider themselves, at least suggested, to be a very universal team, in the sense that they are mixed in both swords and bow. They are the strongest in 1v1s, but they do also consider their team fights to be rather good. They will aim for the scavenge in this match, and they consider their offense to be the best, so we're going to probably see them rely on that in this game. They say that they have two experienced defenders, but regardless of that, the offense is going to be the strongest. They are really good at adapting to the map and the team they're playing against. They scrim 1 to 2 times a week, and we're also seeing cannon fire going off right here. But yeah, they only stream 1 to 2 times a week, so compared to some of the Spanish teams who stream like 20 times a week, there's nothing much to talk about there. It's the first tournament together. They think that their communication is good for the most part. They play for fun, so they're not really in it to win it, but they still want to beat these guys and show who they are. They can't really say anything about how they're going to do in the invitationals because of their activity, but they're fairly confident that they'll at least take this one.
This on the right set now, and they're winning cannons, it looks like.
Yes.
I want me to talk about Impact now.
Yeah, you can talk a bit about Impact.
Alright, Impact is obviously a long-standing team from Tourney 1, going all this way to 9 tourneys. And they say they are pretty good on offense and defense, and I guess that's what you would expect. And they say that they are aiming for a top 4 finish on this tournament. And when they were asked about their communication, they said it used to be horrible, but they have gotten better, hopefully. And I guess that's about it. And they say that they are better on swords with members like PM Haze and Idiots on Mac, who are known to be skilled PvPers.
Alright, so I suggest there's more mixed regarding So versus Bo. So we'll probably see Impact going to be the ones who will prefer to force the issues when the game will inevitably go to the Skybridge, where Suggesta will hold back and try to fight them with the bow. But so far, Impact has a very nice cannon lead, so I'm not even sure if they are interested in setting up their Skybridge at the moment.
Yeah, it looks like Impact is just setting up cannon dominance on all the front side, and they have a huge row of 303s here.
Yes.
Especially here on the right. I wonder if they're trying to push through here later on the game, maybe?
They're probably going to just apply that immense pressure with the cannons and slowly starve out Suggesta. And they already have a touch in the East Monument.
Yeah, that's good.
From the cannons, it seems, yeah?
Yeah. And on the center, just Jedi is trying to set up some sort of cannon. It's like this double 303 looks like whiskey, I don't know.
That's a hybrid. They're probably going to turn on this wall and then it'll shoot from it. But it seems that Impact is prepared with their own water wall and they're going to expand it now. Which is very smart.
Behind the Eclipse.
Yeah. So heavy cannon fire right here. Oh, that's a nice shot.
This Eclipse, this huge tower, I think this will be coming to use soon.
That will be the start of the Skybridge.
Yeah, this is really well defended.
Very good spot indeed, also. And they're setting up the water here, probably to be able to fall down quicker, I could imagine.
Just Jedi on right side is 3-man Icarus now, Diamond, right. And they are up, and they are coming down.
Suggest is already going with the, they had to do this also.
Yeah, they have like three guys on their side now, and one is going for the monument.
But Suggest were forced to do this, seeing as they had completely lost the cannon front.
Yeah, it was a good idea.
More of them seem to snake. I have to do the toggle DM here. Sorry, guys. And so we can see Jar has sneaked into the opponent's base impact.
Actually, there are two guys here.
Oh, by the way, I forgot to turn on the follower thing for you guys who like that stuff.
Yep, Charles and Nikwix are currently tunneling inside impact side, and they are...
Oh, they're together even. That's so smart of them.
Oh,
I like this play.
Splitting up now.
Or...
Yeah, Nikwix yes. is going up here.
So they're very ambitious about this, because usually I would say going two is very strong, but I could also imagine that they want to, you know, like, try to spread some kind of chaos on impact sites. Yes! Alright, anyway.
Yeah, I mean, Impact has pretty good defense on their core, so I don't think they can, like, get, mm-hmm. get an easy touch on it.
Is Nick West going for the core here?
He's on the TNT house below it.
He's definitely going for that.
He's coming from behind, I think. I will see if I like originality can get a defense up before Nikwix comes here.
Yes! Yes! Some yes in the chat right now, what the hell. But yeah. I need to fix that. But so far you can see that Suggestor's doing the smart thing here and watering their core from the top. They're just destroying all the stone around it. I suggest I got some of the... that's a lot of yeses right now, man. Well, Impact's is destroying the little wood thing here.
Stone and glass.
Yeah. That's smart, that's smart. Holy shit.
And Nikwix is still in impact side, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's coming out now. Through the water.
Man, what an opening. Like, sky bridges, they're just nowhere to be seen. In the other games, we've always seen a sky bridge, but these two teams, they have so much cannon experience that they're just shutting them down from a long range. Look at these cannons. It's amazing work by both teams here. None of them can establish that sky bridge. Because of that, we're going to rely a lot on the Icarus in this game.
Yeah, because it seemed like at the beginning Impact had the lead on cannons, but now it seems like they're pretty even here. Because Gesture has these two giant whips on the back of their land,
yeah,
which
yeah.
are really like hard to counter. Nikwix might have a really good opening on their on this monument soon. There's only like one defender here.
I think I have to turn off the follow notification. It's going insane because of the amount of viewers. Holy.
Moving on, blue impact. PM Haze is expanding the sky bridge now.
Yeah, but it's going to be of short notice because look at this cannon that's just... Oh! Somehow it's self-detonated. But it was going... its purpose was to take out Impact Skybridge here. I have to fix this notification thing. Yeah, this is...
Yeah, both teams are now expanding their sky bridge, and both teams are also encountering some heavy cannon fire. Just Jetta was just shut down. when trying to expand? Yeah, like Impact is almost completely true gesture as garbage, and it will be interesting to see if they can expand this while Impact has that kind of fire going on.
Yeah. It seems like Suggestor's cannon somehow got exploded, so the one that was dedicated to take down the Skybridge. It was right here. It might have been countered by this cannon that they have right in front of it, Impact. And if Suggestor doesn't get anything set up soon, what's going to happen is that Impact will have the Skybridge dominance completely. Because how is Suggestor going to connect it with the constant cannon fire from Impact?
I think like just Jeddah should go like more right at the moment, because like this one lane where they're advancing at the moment is like so blocked, it's impossible to make advances there. Just move like 10 blocks to the right and it's much easier.
Oh yeah, so apparently Nickwick's got both the supplies of Impact. Nice job.
Ooh. He's silent.
There you go. Alright, so Impact, yeah. Oh, but now Suggestor got that very, very important cannon going right from the spawn.
Oh yeah, that is an excellent cannon. It pummels right at their sky beach and...
But we have Emo Haze right here. Oh, who's that? Is that PM Haze?
Yeah, no disc left here. At the sky beach at the moment.
I'm thinking about Emo Haze. Oh, Ego Haze. Oh. Well,
that's
he did a very good job at...
Oh no, look at this counter. Just Jeddah's cannon is gone here. Looks like Impact had a counter somewhere here, but I can't find it at all. Oh yeah, it's up front here. But it looks like on this map we have lots of these really long range cannon battles with like 100 blocks between the cannons.
Yes.
It requires them more than an ordinary whiskey.
Right now, Impact really seems organized. I know they lost both the houses here, but regardless of that, they really have the front established. And how are you supposed to put up with this? Suggestor is like in ruins right now. But beforehand, we also heard from Asaron. I quickly heard some stuff from him. They have no shot caller this game. The guy who usually calls the incomings, what's going to happen, what are we going to do, he's not there. So this might be the reason why they're kind of unorganized, it seems. Or just losing the front line, because nobody's making anything. Suggestor only have one guy dedicated to the Skybridge. Impact has three right now, and they're expanding it.
Impact is doing something pretty clever here. They are putting weather in front of their cannons here, so they can be blown up.
Yes. Very smart. And the cannon that Suggestor had before got countered by Impact.
Yeah.
Again, here we have it. Boom! Asaron! He's like, what the hell am I going to do? Alright, I'll just fire this whip. Since I have nothing better to do. But that's not the answer right now, Asaron. It's really not the answer.
I wonder what Impact is doing here. They have put up like a wall here. And I don't know what they're doing with it.
They are trying to block cannon fire. It hits here and then it falls down and...
But I mean, do they have any cannons here? It doesn't look like it.
It keeps getting countered. Asaron tried to set up one before, instantly countered by Impact. They have great support fire. Great support fire from the bottom. Just helping their Skybridge advancing. I think, they're really spreading out that Skybridge right now. Making it impossible to counter with one cannon.
Yeah, this is a good idea to like have this really wide sky bridge that cannot be countered with a single cannon.
It's like an insurance. How do you say it? Ooh, but that's so smart. Oh, they got a guy there. That was the whip. That was Esoran's whip. So what he does is that he fires one of the loads first, then midair, look. And then midair, some of it's going to get redirected, and boom, some will go up and hit. That's what at least happened before.
Oh yeah, that's smart. But it needs more power, I think. It looks like.
Yeah. Well, sometimes it hits, sometimes it doesn't. It's not really reliable, but it's the best bet. Here it goes again. It's too far.
Yeah, and too long timing. And I mean, just doing what they can, because currently this whip here is pretty much the only cannon they have in use that Impact has encountered. So they gotta make the most of it.
Someone asked about the IP in chat. This is a tournament right now, so it's not something you can just join. These two teams have played for 4 weeks now to get where they are. Both have been undefeated, and now they're duking it up, seeing who can get the best seat for the Invitational. You can join the actual server on us.oc.tc. us.oc.tc. But this is organized tournament play. It's not going to be this organized. And Suggesta is, yeah, they're seeing, and this is where we talked about how they are, like, at least they said, how adaptive they are. And this might have been, what can you say, stolen from Impact, in the sense that they said, hey, that's working for them, let's do the same.
Yeah, that's clever. And it's really good for, like, putting at least some resistance here, and they can expand from here.
Oh, the whip gets one!
Oh, nice. It's really good.
He's giving it more power. This is what they need. And now they're trying to set up cannons behind it. Shiny, I think, is going to try to go for that wall that's going to block the TNT while Wolf is setting up the 303. The web is firing again. Can it do the same amount of damage? It will. This is great, great, great. The web is super good here.
And that's an advantage of having a whip so far back, because this is much harder to counter than if it were on the front line. They cannot do pretty much anything about this at the moment.
This is a very stalemated match right now, and I like this, because there's a lot of tactical stuff going on here. We haven't seen the underbridge yet. I think that might be underestimated. There's a lot of potential when it comes to that skybridge, or that underbridge. Give me a second.
Impact is interesting that their two monuments have different defenses. On the left they have pretty much nothing around it, and on the right they have this bridge going next to it. It's interesting that they chose two different styles for it.
Indeed. But I think that if Suggesta wants to get back into this, they have to try more Icarus. It's the only way to try to tie it out right now. I cannot see them get a foothold because of the cannon front of Impact. While it just looks like a lot of water, let's take a look behind it. Cannons. The mid has been destroyed by the whip, and that's great, but still, the cannon front is there. Still, Suggesta is coming up with something now. An answer, perhaps, in these cannons they have here. And perhaps they can set something up. But they'll have to be quick about it. And now Impact is expanding the skybridge.
Oh yeah, but we look at that. Two people. Just like that. Two diamonds going down. And that was like Clef and Riley. Really nice.
Hey, Kappa chat. Alright, so the straw poll is out there, guys. If you're just lurking right now, tam out of the stream. Slanging the right button corner, you can do that. Alright, like down here. Tam out, go to the chat, click on the straw poll, vote. After what we've seen so far, 20 minutes into the game, who's going to take this? So far, I'm not really sure about it, because Impact, they have the sky bridge, but suggest they have a... Oh, it got countered, the whip. Regardless of that, they have a new whip up.
And oh yeah, on the right side.
Yes, on the right side. So they're relentless. They're not going to take it just like that, in my opinion. Suggest that
they have already cannon there. Oh, look at that. Yes. Look at that.
And yeah, they keep carrying each other's sky bridges. They're not getting connected at all.
Yeah, this is really high level cannon play here. Just going back and forth currently. Oh, and for those who don't know, I'm Koipen.
Looking at the results so far, it's actually very even. 60% says Impact will take this, Suggesta says 40%. 40% says that Suggesta will take this. And I understand those votes.
Yeah, Nickwick's just got a touch on Impact's monument east again.
Yes, it's like, was that the Icarus? I didn't quite see it. It's a Cairns right now, if you ask me.
It was hard to see. He just like, I think it was Icarus.
All right. We'll have to pay very close attention to what happens on each side right now, because a lot of stuff is happening. Whether you would like to focus on the individual player or the teams as a whole. But the whip, it's back up. They have two whips right now for Suggesta, and we know what these whips can do. You should not joke around with them.
Yeah, this is pretty interesting. If you look at the middle, there's like no bridges across yet. It's all Icarus so far.
What do we have here? Oh, more watering from Suggesta.
Oh, Suggesta has a really good opposition on the sky, which they have two guys in diamond, and Impact has only like iron guys. And Impact is getting really hard cannon fire at the moment.
I see. It might have something to do with the lack of diamond armor on Impact side. Because Suggesta is setting up those diamond guys and they can just tank those shots. 10 shots! Whereas Impact only can take 5. And so, and one of them just got shot down.
Look like Suggesta, they are like pushing forward at the moment.
They have seemed to have recovered with those whips. There's a lot of yes in the chat. Regardless of that, while Impact seems to have it in the start, they are not really having any diamond guys dedicated to the sky bridge. I understand that because it's more risky, but because of it, Suggesta is right now seeming to win the sky bridge war. However, they have to care a lot. If they get shut down with a cannon or so, they might not hit that water and they will die. And they will lose that precious diamond armor.
Currently, Suggesta has both like the cannon fire and the arrow. Domination, so it will be interesting to see if they can push forward now.
The whips really seem to be what's making the difference right now.
Oh, but look at like Impact has shot a cannon here too, though, so they aren't like completely true yet. Just yet, I mean.
See, that whip. The whip is just tearing through their side right now. Very smart use of the whip. I like this.
Really like pays to invest in a large cannon like this because it does so much more damage than a like 303 or something.
Exactly.
But it's very even at the moment, so hard to tell what it's going to be. Just Jedi is currently leading by a single block.
It's really, really, really close, but so far the overall ferret that chat see is Impact. So, but that was also created while Impact had one touch more than Suggesta. I'm actually not sure if we're ever going to see the Skybridge actually reach the other side. Impact is close right now, but they do not want to sacrifice that armor. Let me tell.
And Icarus is going off.
Oh, yes. This is what I like. It's iron, though, so they're going to go quite low right here. Let's see what they can do. Fire in the hole. Whew. Like a shooting star.
So high.
They're just gonna bombard those.
And right in the water.
And Nickwicks is going to probably TNT run their Skype. No, he's going for the monument. He sees that as
Charles the... noticed him immediately. He's dead already.
Alright. I'm not sure if he wasted his chance there. Because I think that if they really want to get dominance of the Skybridge, they can, like, one TNT rush of that diamond, or like, of the cannons would do greatly. But he's spotted now. What happened to the other player?
He died.
Ah, Jarl.
He was spotted immediately.
Alright, so it's only Nickwicks left. The Finnish hope.
Yeah, like, I think he will just, like, tunnel in and hide there for 5 minutes or something and then come out and tunnel like forward to the monument.
I don't know if you guys have heard this already, but we talked about it earlier. So what this map does do very greatly is that it promotes this sneaky kind of offender. This is like, while this map also helps, like also supports like team fight, pretty much every map does that. This map especially encourages, you know, people who try to go by themselves. And not that much team pushes, in the sense that the map, it's so, there's so much height difference. If one guy gets knocked down, he'll suddenly be at like 0 HP or 5 HP. It's very hard to stay together as a team, but if you're going by yourself, you can be a pain in the butt.
Speaking of Charlie's cursing again, he's landing now. Oh yeah, right in the moment, almost on top.
Alright. And Nickworks is still on impact site. This seems to be what's giving them the cutting edge right now. Oh, this is kinda smart. Making sure that he cannot just knock him away immediately. But he's so far away already. And you know what? Impact doesn't have two defenders. Which means that I lack originality, cannot go for him. However, he can tell his friend, hey mate, can you take care of him? However, while all of this is going on, the battlefield is being opened. And this is suggests us, you know, time to push for it.
Currently, like, Cheshire is in a really good position because they have two guys on impact side and both can be going on the same monument and it's very hard to know where they are because they're both like tunneled in all the way. I think we might see a new monument at June.
I do not want to see Dota 2 versus League things in the chat, guys. And please, if you guys have any constructive to say in the chat, please do. There's a lot of you guys out there, so do not be afraid. We can take some of the stuff off you guys say if we find it interesting. So far, though,
Ego is up on the sky beach here and expanding. Yes! Hiding in no armor.
I'm not sure what his plan is. Yeah, I think he's supposed to be the guy who just suicides. But he goes in with a starter kit, just tries to expand it. But this is what we're told about before the match, guys. If you weren't there, Impact are going to be the team that has to force the issue.
Nickwick's got a touch,
and he's dead though already. But he might have got a quick touch. This is what we're talking about. Let's see, Charles is still alive. Yes! Charles is Icarusing again. Was he going to land though? He's falling down right now. They're shooting arrows up into the air, but I don't think they actually saw him.
Oh yeah, he's so far down, it's so dark and watery. It's hard to know where people go.
Something tells me that this is going to stress Impact by a great deal, in the sense that these guys, like, how are you supposed to deal with this? I'm actually stuck right here.
Oh, yeah, they have like all these little ants stuck on their side and there's no way to know where they are.
They're just like, it's kind of like, and suggest you also got a touch on the core. Oh, that was Nickwix before, right? Yeah, alright, good, good, good. I was about to say that I thought it was from the monument. But that core touch can prove to be very, very important.
Because yeah, just Jedi's core, like, it's covered in crafting tables, so they are really, like, prepared for not getting a touch there at all.
They completely destroyed everything around it. It's going... it's really going to take a lot from Impact to get this. Regardless though, if you're new to the stream and you haven't seen what this is all about, guys, we're seeing team-based PvP in Minecraft, alright? We're having two teams, they have some objectives, they have to destroy a monument and a core, that's what it's about. If you make the core leak, there's lava inside it, if that flows out of it, you'll get a core leak, and if you destroy some of the blocks on this monument here, you'll get monument leaks. It's very coordinated.
Eclipsen.
Yes.
Did you notice that Nickwick just left?
Did he just leave?
He left.
Who got swapped in?
I don't know. I don't have too much to say, but I noticed he left.
Perhaps he couldn't play anymore, or they have some kind of late game strategy. He was maybe supposed to be the guy who puts the pressure in the beginning, but now there's not really any more use for him because they don't. They think they have a better PvPer, maybe?
Yeah,
a guy who's better at sneaking.
Remember that Nickwix already got like one core touch and one element touch.
And so it's kind of weird why you would want to swap him out, so I think he had to go actually. Because he's done so much for Sagista right now.
Ooh, camera blew up on Ego's face.
But yeah, guys, if you want to try this kind of game mode on, go to us.oc.tc. If someone could type it in chat to give it to the new people who are coming, I thank you guys for the follows. But right now, we're still not seeing these sky bridges connected to each other. And that is completely because of these cannons. Alright, these followers are actually getting out of hand right now, so if you guys keep doing those, I'm actually gonna turn it off. Alright, I'm serious right now. Alright. But so far, now it seems to be Suggester who wants to connect it. I can understand that though, because the front line is opened up. And look at Impact's once glory sky bridge with all of its stone. It's like gone. It's gone. But right now, Impact is also doing their cannons. Oh, cutting one of the diamond guys off. You guys saw that, right? I hope you did.
Oh yeah, that's brilliant.
So he activates one TNT later than the other. How? Yeah, he does that. He does that. You see, no, this time he didn't. But before one of them got knocked down.
Yeah, like that's something new we have seen this turn, is like these cannons which have like propellants that launch in the air.
That's very, very clever.
Yeah, we saw like the
cannons are just flying in the air right now, boys.
TNT, not cannons.
I mean TNT, yes. Thank you for the correction. But look at both sides right now. When you look at the sides, it's actually kind of hard to find out like who is actually in the lead, because both sides looks like a mess.
Yeah, like imagine trying to find a player down here. It's impossible. It's a big map.
Let's see. Do we still have the Icarus, or is that completely destroyed for Suggester's side? Seems to be gone. It was here, right? All right then. They might want to go all in on this garbage now.
Eclipse him.
Yes.
Mind tipping here. Chester has like interesting defense here with gravel.
Ah. Oh.
And chest, it's like really weird, I think.
It's to prevent the pressure plate, I think, trick.
Yeah, I think it's pretty smart.
Yeah, that's very smart. We saw an offensive way of doing this, where you can like break one of the gravels together with a piece of TNT, and then it actually won't be covered in water. That's pretty smart. So you would like break, you would put TNT on top of the gravel, you would break the, you would like ignite the TNT, break the TNT would be inside of the gravel, and then it wouldn't be affected by the water reduction, damage reduction. I do not see how Suggester can expand the sky bridge, and it doesn't really look like they're that interested, because they're only having two guys dedicated to it. Same way for Impact. I think this is going to be the game of Icarus's. However, it's Impact who's going to be to force the issue, in the sense that they're behind a core touch. That means that the other team have touched the core with the mine pick or whatever, and they've got more of the monument. They've got five blocks. The other team only have four blocks. That's Impact.
And remember, we are currently like over halfway through this match. We are at like 33 minutes played at the moment.
Yeah, exactly.
Also interesting is that like if you look at the enemy side from the middle, it's impossible to see where cannons are at the moment. So it's a bit of a like a stealth factor to cannoning, because you can hide behind all these
waters. Oh yes, yeah, you can hide behind all the sky bridges as well. The sky bridge will actually give you cover. Alright, and they're now setting up yet, and wait, this is Impact this time. Impact is going to return the favor with an Icarus of their own. If you guys do not know what the Icarus is and you're new to the stream, alright, this is what it's about. You use TNT to launch yourself as a projectile, like the actual TNT itself. So you activate this, you just stand here, you jump, and you hold a sword, so you will reduce the damage, and then you'll get flown up high into the air, and you'll be able to land on the other side with reduced HP, obviously. But it seems
Clav is going on diamond.
Clav is going now.
And Riley boat.
They're both going up. Where are they at though?
I see one.
There they came down. Whoa, they flew so up, and right on top of the monument. This is huge. Can they stop it? Carlos Forge doesn't see him, because he's looking at the other guy, but he's being shot down. the Skybridge is helping with the defense right now. This is great communication by Sagesta. Instead of just letting their defenders deal with it, they're calling it out and everyone turns around to help.
Yeah, very fast defense, very fast.
Good job.
And not a single touch, that's really great.
Yeah, especially when you think about it, that both of them landed right on top of this.
Yeah. It's like a very good Icarus, but also a very good defense.
This is kind of what you want to take down the Skybridge, even on their side. Because...
Look at the impact. Skybridge was expanding super fast.
Yeah.
By Ego.
Yeah, PM Hayes, right? He's very good at doing the straight bridge. So if you guys do not know what a straight bridge is, as I'm also going to explain that, it's where you have a block here, you like place a block, and then you like quickly uncrouch, move a bit more, and then quickly crouch, place a block, and you just do that super fast.
Oh, but Jedi's cannoning them.
They're cannoning from the top right now, but they have the water wall set up, so this shouldn't be able to do anything. Oh!
No, it does.
Oh, Esron, a big hit there, man. And that's... That's what you said before, Koyben, with the bridge giving great cover for cannons. And Azeron saw that, and took great advantage of it.
Yeah. That came from like below, and so it was really hard to see and really hard to protect against. And now look at just Jedi Sky, which it's like advancing fast. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, they're advancing now. And like impact, they cannot really do anything against him because currently their Skybridge is in stretch, basically here.
Oh, this match, dude! Oh, look at this fire! No, he did. Oh, Shiny almost got taken down right there by that TNT. Icarus is like a man with some wings. That's all I know about it from Greek. Oh wait, he's just clearing out it. Oh! Really? Riley got under it and got a complete monument. He got inside it, he digged inside and he got it. That's huge for impact. He got inside it, he put down a pressure plate, he then put some TNT right above it, he shot an arrow down at the pressure plate. The pressure plate activated the TNT, the TNT falls down onto the pressure plate protected the TNT from the water reduction, so it would just destroy the entire thing. Very great very play smooth. By Riley.
Yeah. And that basically like changed the entire match now.
Yeah.
Because Impact now has the lead.
Sagesta was the ones who could just sit back, be like, we can just relax, like, we have the lead. But now, tables have turned, and you know what? Impact is like, we're not gonna play it like Sagesta. We're not gonna just hold the Skybridge, be passive about it. No. They can smell the blood.
Oh, look at that.
And PM Hayes is scoring for it together with Riley. Very fast bridge.
Damn.
And they need reinforcements now. Because they are losing. Skybridge is also connected for the first time 38 minutes into the game, guys. This is huge. But they have to watch out they don't lose it now, Impact, because otherwise this will be used against them.
I mean, look at these cannons. They aren't.
Oh no. This is bad, actually. Because they went over there with unarmored guys. Yes!
Oh yeah, look at now. 3 diamond guys from just Jedi going on Skybridge. This is huge. This
could
be major.
Yeah, they're gonna be pushing on now. And now... now PMAs might have regret that he act... No! One of them got shot out of the world! That's diamond armor! Huge! But can they connect? They cannot afford losing more diamond armor. This might be very bad for Sagesta. There's only one guy left. One guy is down. Keshla Forge. Can he go for the monument while the others are being distracted? This might actually be super smart. No, he fell out of the world as well. He's in the water.
Not yet. He's in the water.
But he's going to get knocked out now. He's gone.
Yeah, he's
this out. Is huge. But Keshla Forge, behind all of this, is going to try to get a monument touch. He actually managed to get some of it, but it's not enough. This defense right here.
But he's back, he's down under again.
And look at this. Gibbs is going for him. Can he find him? Can he get the connection? He's not sure where he is.
Oh man, this game is all over at the moment.
It's all over the place, mate. So Impact is now reinforcing the bridge. They want to take this, despite Suggesta being the more armored team right now. Oh, they broke it apart. I think that was Suggesta who did that. They don't, I guess they don't want the connection. Or, wait, no. Babu was almost about to expand there. Yes, I do not think that Suggesta wants to actually connect the Skybridge. Because...
Look at the Impact, look at this whip by Impact. This could be huge. Oh, but it's wrong, in the wrong place, I think.
Ah, muck. Muck. I set up a nice whip right now. Let's see what it can do. If he activates one of the TNTs...
Anything at the moment.
If he could... It hits the back of the Skybridge. A slight bit. What he could do is that he could activate the TNT on the right. Like, first the base TNT, right? Then the TNT on the right. And then the on the... Yeah, I mean, on the left. And then on the right. So that it would, like, knock the TNT into the Skybridge. Like, he just did that.
He's trying to do that.
Smart. Whips are, like, very good at dealing with Skybridge. I had no idea it would be this effective.
Yeah, it's all about timing with whips. You need just the right timing and it does wonders.
Oh.
It's like eating away half of their Skybridge at the moment.
But yeah, I understand why Suggesta do not want to connect the Skybridge right now, because they probably also, as Impact know, that Impact is superior at melee combat, PvP. What's happening here? They're all rushing to a specific spot, it seems like. Are they just trying to... Who are they going... Oh, it's still Califorge, or whatever it's called. He's causing a lot of trouble for Impact. And while this might look... he fed them the armor. He tried to aim for the water so he could fall out of the world with it, but now they have the diamond armor. Otherwise, I think that diamond armor actually paid itself off. In this sense that he took so much of their concentration or focus. So, and that opened up the map. The web is going off again. Can it hit anything? No.
But right now, Chester really needs like one objective completed, and that would be like really good for them because they have touched on all three at the moment.
I'm streaming uphill. That would be, otherwise it would be way too hard for me. Bisipula, who asked if I'm leaning to forward the whole time.
Impact is expanding at the moment, Skybridge.
Yeah, Impact wants to connect it yet again. Which is understandable. They want to force issue, and we are seeing an underbridge right now. Oh, did we not notice this? Who created this? Let's see if we can find out.
It went to this direction.
So it went towards Impact side?
Yeah.
Alright. But, and like, this is what's very great, because Impact seems to be very, very focused on the Skybridge right now. So going for an underbridge is not a bad idea at all. Look, it's been there for like some time right now. Especially when you consider it's being a tournament match. It's been there for some time. A minute or two. And nobody's seen it yet. But since, and you can also tell that Suggesta made it because, says Jira or whatever. They made it because Mr. Bleeple, it's got Bleeble right, yeah. He's having an eye on it. But as we speak, like, they're really putting pressure on the Skybridge.
This Impact is destroying it. It's gone.
It's gone, alright.
Oh no,
it's... No! Oh, he got shot out of the world by Bleeble. Great shot. That was some quick reaction time right there. This is not what Impact want at all. They want to take it Oh, whoa. There's another guy on said Impact side. Who is it this time? It's Jarl again. You can see what kind of style that Suggesta is going for compared to. He's going to get out of the world though. But the guy was there. But yeah, Impact wants to be the team that focus a lot on the team play, whereas Suggesta is going for the small rushes over there quickly. I'm gonna turn up that MC sound so we can hear those cannons going off.
Manly.
I know the classic saying that Sas doesn't know, but we've seen that the Acheras are just as fine, in the sense that they've got over there a multitude of times.
Yeah, Impact is trying to advance, and they are actually pretty far ahead at the moment.
Yeah.
But Yoshida is like on arrow lockdown at the moment.
I think it's only a matter of time before Impact is actually going to connect the Skybridge. So Yoshida has to make something happen very, very soon. But do you actually know if a core touch, like who's actually winning right now? Because Yoshida has the core touch.
Impact. They have a completed objective.
All right, so that counts. That trumps everything.
I think yeah.
All right. Alright, if anyone could type the IP of where this stuff is going on usually, or like pretty much 24/7, please do so in the chat, us.o.tc guys. This is where you find this kind of PV action we're witnessing right now between these two teams. You can go there and try out the game mode yourself if you want to. And boom! Boom, both ways! Suggest that also has his own cannon up. Shouldn't wonder me if it's Azeron who's dedicated to that, since he's been doing that for a very long time. Yes, it's still Azeron who's just pressuring that with that TNT. He probably can't see it though. He's in the back there, coming to the spawn. Look, boom.
Yeah.
He's trying to cut it off. They do not want this to connect. It's clear right now.
Trying to make a cannon here. Look at this. There's like redstone here.
Looks like yeah. It's an Icarus.
Oh yeah, it is. They're building it at that moment.
Oh, but he got cannon by Azeron. He's on point with that cannon. I'm certain that what we're seeing right now is Timuro and Pipita just telling Azeron whether or not he should adjust the cannon. We need a bit more height, we need a little bit less height, it needs to go a bit longer. Like that, like so.
Yeah, that cannon is golden at the moment. It's sitting right where it needs to be.
And also, suggest they're sending over two members on the underbridge right now. You can tell what kind of style they're going for, Suggestia. They're just hoping for those touches. Because they know, if they can get a monument, they got this because of the touch in the core. And that's what they can pray to do right now. However, Carla has been shut down right away. Perhaps it's time to use the second underbridge, since Impact is now focused on this underbridge that they failed to take out earlier.
Yeah, Carla's trying to go for it. And there are actually two people here. Oh man.
They shouldn't be able to take down Hyla.
Oh yeah.
Taken down without much trouble. A very, very tense game right now between these two 4-0 teams.
Oh, look at this. Oh, it's blue. Never mind.
Alright. Man. Camerate Batch extending that Skybridge right now. They really want to connect it, but I'm not sure how they can do it. Because Azeron, look. Is that him who's trying to set up a cannon right now? He's moving on to the front lines. Oh, he's been called out there to help. Riley Numbers is on it. Probably the Skybridge. Probably the Icarus, but he's taken down right away. But now Azeron will go back to his lovely cannon over here and keep firing that, even though he might want to rebuild this whip cannon right here so it can shoot down the progress that they've made so far.
This smart move from Impact, they're like expanding the sky beach sideways, so they need more cannons, and that always takes like more manpower to build.
An interesting note I have to say right now, if and only if Sashjira manage to take it to Boom, is that I have reliable sources that says that Impact, every time they have scrimmed Boom, they have never lost Boom before in a scrim. Never. Impact have never lost a Boom before. So I'm not even sure if it's what Suggestor wants. But that will only happen if Impact also manages to get a core touch. It's so unrealistic it's going to happen, but only if Impact is undefeated on Boom. You do not want to fight them there.
Boom.
The Boom Man. And look. Is that a player? No, that's an observer. I'm gonna turn off observers, I think.
Oh, look at this cannon on the sky beach.
I see it's impact, right? Yeah, they want to cut off the reinforcements for Sagista. But Babaluba is on point and repairing that sky bridge right away.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, that's so huge. Nice. They just took down the front line. Like, now they're going, like, this guy is going to take some heavy bow fire right now. This cannon is doing a lot for them, and they are probably saying, Esseron, with your mighty cannons, please help us. We need assistance. But guess what? He is not there. Nobody's there. No cannon support anymore.
Oh, look at this. Perfect. Almost. He's in the water stream at the moment. Oh, no, he's going down. I think they're like, they have to rethink this idea.
Oh. And I can actually tell what's making Impact win the Skybridge War right now. It's the fact that Esseron is the player that when someone gets onto their side, he's supposed to go there and take them out. You can see that every time Impact gets one over there, he's just running out there and trying to support. He's like that supportive player. But now that they're, and when they're then pushing, like they're on their side and at the same time pushing the Skybridge, they can't, like, they're gonna win the sky bridge because Esseron is no longer there to help them. You know what I'm saying, Kirk?
Yeah. They need, like, another man for cannons and another for defense.
Your two cannons have no power in my chat. Get timed out, boys.
Impact is expanding, yeah, Impact is almost there. Yeah, they're true. They're on
just all right, yeah. Well, I just timed out some of those bad boys. Yeah, Impact. Take the garbage, and right now, I honestly do not know what Sagesta can do.
Like, guys, that's a lot.
They have put themselves on top of this. But look, great play from Sagesta. Everyone's just pointing their arrows towards the sky. However, this is going to open the match up, open the map up by a lot for Impact. They're going to have so much space created right now. What is the actual bet here? They don't even have a cannon to set this up. They need to set up a cannon from down here, shooting from the side, but even that won't take all of it out.
But this is what Impact is trying to do here, because like they aren't reaching anywhere or doing anything like expansion. They're just like holding it at the moment.
Yeah. I think they just want to lock down the match because they know they have the lead. So, by taking the sky bridge.
Look at this. Oh man, that's smart. But it doesn't work.
Oh, he tried to...
With gravel.
Oh. It works! They can get a touch right now. They're gonna get a touch!
No!
It's so close, though.
They need pressure plates. They're, like, quick. I mean, not pressure plates, but, like, slabs here. Oh, damn. That's really hardcore.
Yeah, oh my god, that's devastating, man. If Sagesta, if they get the core touch, they're really screwed. But I think they ran out of gravel right now. Does he have more gravel on him? He doesn't have any more gravel. Alright. This. Alright.
Yeah.
Oh
man.
They got the core from beneath then. So that was the point of the sky bridge. While they were being pressured, and everyone had their eyes, even us, the streamers, our eyes focused at the sky bridge. They had a guy sneak in from the bottom. That's very smart.
Smart.
Yeah, very, smart. Very, very smart. Yeah, as Plastic says it in the chat right now, we need a miracle. I'm in need of a miracle! Yeah, they need both monuments and a core. Like, I'm not sure what Suggest Acts can do right here. The moment they lost the Skybridge, they lost the game pretty much. Like, if it wasn't already lost. But what seemed to give Impact the edge was when Esseron stopped cannoning. When he went on to try to help his team, shutting down the guys who, you know, sneaked onto the sites, there was nobody to cannon anymore for them. And when they didn't have the cannon support, they just lost it. However, it took them 50 minutes to connect the Skybridge and get actually control of the Skybridge.
Yeah, I mean, it was really well played up to that point, but like at that point, they just needed like more guys, more people.
It seems kinda random what Suggest is doing right now. I guess they're scattered. They just got shut down here. They're trying hard to get over there. Look, Azeron, he's trying to get over there with no armor at all, but he's being shot down from the sky bridge. There's really nothing they can do.
Yeah, it's very painful
Azeron
because
is
it's like
about to
5 minutes.
fall. Sorry, what?
It's very pain looping at the moment because it's only 5 minutes to go.
But as I just said, as Azeron just died, so did his team. Whoa.
Oh, poetic.
They're just trying to prolong the game, stop the bleeding. They at least want to go down with some kind of honor. Or
Yeah.
respect, however you want like to put it. Dignity.
But I mean, it was definitely not a bad match. Like, they put up a really good
No, they
fight.
put up a fight. Like, don't get me wrong. This was no way, like nowhere near dominated by Impact. It's only towards these last minutes that they put themselves on top of this match. Before
Yeah, and
that,
it's
no,
like
like.
clear that these are like two top teams here. I think like Impact will probably
Let
get
me
like
see.
seed number one, and Chicharito might get seed number three maybe now.
The straw poll right now, right, says that like when we actually did the straw poll mid game, like 56% says that Impact, 44% said Suggesta, and that was 20 minutes into the game. That tells something about how close these two teams were. And Azeron is finally back in the cannon, and that's where he's supposed to be. And I feel like when he left that cannon, the team it just started crumbling. He had to like they had to stay on that the entire game.
Yeah.
That's what seemingly cost the game, in my opinion. And then the Riley monument story. Also, when they lost Nidquix, their offense just were gone. There was nothing left. Like
Yeah, I mean,
Nidquix
I don't
seemed
know
to
what
be
was
their.
next then.
Yeah, I don't know what it was, but like Nidquix seemed to be their entire offense. Now without him,
Yeah, like
they don't have anyone to push for.
this is like the perfect map for Nidquix because it's so much about solo push, and Nidquix is like a special guy on those things. Maybe it was coming late for him because it's like half past midnight at the moment in Finland.
Pops, it got too late. Yeah.
Yeah, it could be.
Wow.
Oh dear.
Look, they're doing the cannon so again, where they have the cannon that redirects the fire. Or they have one piece of TNT that does it. And now they're just expanding the bridge. They're on top of Suggesta's site. Like, they've kind of already given up. I mean, what's left for them to do? He can just block spam the monument, try to get inside it. They're really just trying to keep the dignity in this. And for the guys who's joining, this game is about to end right now, but if you want to try this yourself, go on the server
Oh, look at this.
us.oc.tc.
Clef is inside a monument. It's over, maybe.
Yeah,
Look at this.
he got inside it, but he didn't get it all of it.
Oh,
However, he
completely.
connected the sky bridge to it. It's right, like, so it's only a matter of time.
Oh, yeah, this could be it.
Yeah. Whew, Shiny got some of the core. They leaked the core. But
Oh,
whoa, whoa,
wow.
whoa, 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 whoa. Is this a potential comeback? Nah,
I
it's
fear it.
they still need. Nah, there's no way. They need to get both monuments, and they only have 1 minute.
It's like this one
Sex
last
legged.
week and everything is happening.
Yeah, and look, Impact, they're just jumping the monument. Well, I
Okay,
guess
but we need.
they want some kind of result, I guess. They want to show that they're not nothing. We at least went down with a bang, but now Klaff is on top of it again. Azeron, can you stop him? I fear he can't because of his lack of
Oh,
armor and.
Clef, look at this. Clef might be. Clef.
Nah.
Oh, never mind. Almost.
But yeah, losing Nidquix really seemed to be the thing that destroyed it for Suggesta. But yeah, guys. as the chat said, or someone in the chat just said, that court leak from Segesta, it was a bit late, a bit too late. All right, when yes. Some yes. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
GG.
GG. GG. It was a very good game, boys. GG.